Greetings, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Azure Seas of Nether. I am Der Heizmeister, and this is finally episode 1 of the Quest for Nether campaign. Yes, it is finally time to start the campaign. The preparations are complete, and without further ado, I would like to start a new campaign, please. And it is, of course, the main campaign, Quest for Nether. If you would like to read the story that leads up to the Quest for Nether campaign, then feel free to do so. You may pause the video now to read this story, and yes, I hope you're finished, because I'm going to start the campaign right now. Okay, I would like to make this fairly quick. So, damage difficulty will be on 100%, meaning I do the same damage as the enemy does. This is a setting I would like to recommend to everyone, fairly balanced, as it should be. Then, enemy growth factor will be set to 185%, and resource given by destroying an enemy will be set to 5%, and this is also the point where I would like to make the first important announcement, a rule for the campaign, so to say. I will not attempt to capture enemy vehicles. I will never attempt to actively capture them. If it may happen that I capture a vehicle by accident, then so be it, but I will not actively attempt any captures. Even if, for say, we have a bulwark and the AI is exposed, and all I need to do is jump on board, hit it a few times with my minigun, and it will be mine. No, I will absolutely not capture any units. I hope I've made this abundantly clear. A complete set of rules for the campaign regarding the playthrough, capture mechanics, and how to handle the sent-in units is also available on the Discord channel. Okay, combat very challenging, supremely challenging. That's a value I'm comfortable with, 2.7. Okay. Everything has been set up. Let's do this. I've been waiting for this moment so long, and I'm sure you have as well. You've been waiting quite some time, haven't you? All right, here we are. It's a pirate's life for me. Yes. It appears that some pirate has pulled a fast one on us, and now we are extremely motivated to begin our operation. Peace was never an option. Yes, that's what the operation is called. Peace was never an option to begin with. Alright, let's get a view of our assets that we start with. We have a little dinky dredge here. Is this? Oh, a starting rip. And the starting fortress. Very basic, nothing special. And I'm sure that some of you have seen this 1,000 times. So, first order of business is to scrap this. Goodbye. Pull all, and I would like to, well, like in every RTS, which is exactly how I will play this campaign. Like an RTS, I will first construct a basic foundation on which to build the economy and our empire upon. Now, retrofitting, please. Yeah, logistics. And I would like to retrofit this starting forge into a little mine. Yep, just enough resources to hold everything. And actually, let's spawn it in. I'm sure some of you haven't seen this one already. This is my mine. There are many like it, but this one is mine. Yes, it is a fairly basic resource building which I will construct on nearly every resource zone, at least initially. Cheap, expendable, and it will mine materials and also process a minuscule amount of fuel. Now, just to make sure this has been set up correctly, you are in resource group 2 as well. Okay. Next up, another important step, is to construct a refinery so that I may produce fuel in sufficient quantities to supply my initial fleet with. Yeah, I'll just leave this there, being constructed for now. How much resources do I have? More than enough. I could actually... Those two should be in a fleet. Okay. And let's have a look. Yeah. You are set up correctly. You are set up correctly as well. Okay. Good. Good. Okay, while this is being constructed, let me just have a look at the map. There's a whole lot of nothingness there. Yeah, my plan is to construct the initial base zone fairly quickly and then set up everything to basically raid deep water guard territories fairly early on. But not that early, that it might be considered a rush, but yeah, early enough before the Deepwater Guard actually declares war on us, so... Please, you may now speed up construction. Actually, let me just speed up time. Constructing, constructing, and finished. Okay, I have a resource extractor, I have fuel processing set up. This is the little refinery. All I need now is a building that is dedicated to the construction of units. Well, just like in a real RTS, this would be a factory or, you know, the barracks of some sorts. Something that you build early on. In this case, it's the creatively named dock. Yeah, I do have a large, let's say, headquarter for building and constructing additional units, but this one will suffice for the start. No, wait. Ah. Construct it. Okay then, I'll be right back. Ah, wonderful. It's a sunny and slightly overcast day here in Nita. And welcome aboard my dock. The small, the initial construction yard where the fleets will be constructed, at least in the early game. Let's take a tour, shall we? Eddie's lieutenant. Okay, yeah, I've had a little bit of fun with mimics on this one. This guy here is apparently pondering this chunk of clearly not Tiberium. And we have a little model, a model of a ship, the SMS Plutos. Yeah, I really did have too much time on my hands and I played with mimics way too much. Okay, now. Enough of that, constructing the first unit. The first unit I would like to construct is something actually quite different, not a combat unit, mind you, but rather something that removes the darkness that currently shrouds the area on the map. Where is it? Where is it? Yes, this is my uncategorized folder right now, where all the prototypes are in there, and some units I've not yet allocated into the correct folders. A radar satellite. Yeah, I need a radar satellite to, well, basically uncover the map, uncover the fog of war, and see what's going on. I will most likely build a lot of these. Yeah. They are powered by RTGs, thus making them fairly self-supplied? No, self-reliant? Self-sufficient? I don't know. Anyway, Houston, we have liftoff. Yeah, this radar satellite will now climb to a height of 2,500 meters. And then I can see a whole lot more what's going on the map. Come on, climb faster. You are in thinner air now and your iron engines should be working. There we go. Unfolding the antennas, pulling some fancy maneuvers. Yep, you look like you have a small problem with your flight controls, my friend. Ah, doesn't matter. It will stabilize itself eventually. There we go. Yeah, everything went just as planned. So, zoom out, and detach the radar satellite. Actually, no, don't detach it. Maybe. Yeah, detach it from the main force.
Moving out.
And there we go. I hope I can see.
Moving out.
Oh, yeah, right.
Moving out.
Track the zoom, and there we go. I can see the first Deepwater Guard emplacements, a fishing village, an airship gantry, and the Sinner's Outpost, which is fully operational and already harvesting resources. This cannot stand. I have 5,000 resources. Yeah, I initially spent a lot on these buildings, I mean, setting up the base zone and a radar satellite, so in this case I could probably turn off the refinery for now and construct something else. But what should it be? Yeah, I'll have a little thinking session about it, and I'll be right back when I've decided on what to construct next. So, I have finally decided on what to build first, and I would like to build an initial attack and raiding force first. That will consist of well, aircraft and maybe one naval unit. We'll see how it goes. So, the first unit I will construct is something which is actually not meant to be in play on its own. This is not the space fighter, the sprite fighter. This is a... well, this is normally a carrier-based aircraft, as its operational range is limited by the amount of fuel it can carry. Yeah, it is also equipped with a custom jet engine, meaning that this one will use up a lot of fuel. So, with that being said, I have normally a few sprite fighters on my carriers, and this is where they should be deployed from. However, this one, yep, is airborne. Good. One sprite fighter. Let's make that two sprite fighters. Or maybe a sprite fighter heavy. This one is called heavy because it has medium missiles instead of the small ones that the regular sprite fighter has. Let's actually have a look at this one. Yeah, fairly simple design, custom jet engine, a few control surfaces, missiles, and that's about it. And as you can see, fuel usage is within tolerable levels, but still a little bit too high to give it a wide operational range. Looks like I ran out of resources. Okay, the Sprite Fighter Heavy is finally operational, and I think it is time to begin the assault on the Deepwater Guard territories. Although I'm not yet equipped to defend myself against any enemy incursions on my territory, let's move the satellite a little bit closer to enemy territory. Okay, yeah, resource groups are set up correctly, and the first target would be these terrain tiles bordering on my zone of operation.
Moving out.
Don't mind me, I'm just having a stroll here into enemy territory. Oh no, my fleets are trespassing. Now, what a shame, isn't it? Come on, get angry. I would like to capture... Oh, there it is. Squatters. Yeah. Have fun. Okay.
Listening. Moving out.
Time to capture this territory. And, yeah, let's see what the Deepwater Guard can throw at me. Well, isn't this a surprise? A flying squirrel has found its way toward my base zone. There it is. Yes, a Deepwater Guard air unit is now on its way to assault my capturing Sprite fighters. Actually, I should probably rename this fleet for now. Let's call it the first Aero Corps. Okay, with that done, please continue your advance, Flying Squirrel.
Listening.
Just a bit more, but not to get blockaded, of course. Perfect. Okay then.
Listening.
I have a Sprite Fighter and a Heavy Sprite Fighter on the field. This should be fairly easy for an initial engagement. Begin. Yeah, your balloon there, you know, this is problematic. Anyway, missiles away, and actually... what a blunder. Just a moment, please. Yeah, it seems that the balloon was set to deploy automatically right after spawning, which was also a setting saved in the blueprint. I've corrected this now, and let's see what happens to this poor flying squirrel. A giant explosion happened. Well, not giant, but a lot of disintegration, block confetti, and victory. Okay, I have moved up my radar satellite to get a better picture of the battlefield, and I can see another resource zone, Captain Nick's last request. Captain Nick of the SS Intelligence. Smart choice for a name. This will be mine. Okay, what's this? A trade fleet? A Simoon. Or is it Sea Moon? Simoon? Probably. Looks like an air unit. Continue capturing. Oh, one moment please. I'm at 17,000 resources right now. Which means that I can construct another unit. Now, once again, a decision has to be made what to build. And I have an idea. Let's continue with the Air Force theme for now. And I would like to build the first unit that has been sent in. Or, well, not the first that has been sent in, but I would like to build a unit that has been sent in. And it's the first I'm going to build which has been sent in. The E-12 Viper. And you should see a little box here in the corner where you could click to see what it does exactly, since I've shown it in a Meet the Fleet video. If you'd like to, of course. What's it called again? The E-12 Viper is equipped with RTGs completely independent from any fuel sources, which, of course, makes its operational range nearly unlimited. Yeah, wonderful. A contrast to my Sprite Fighters, actually. This one is not as fast as the Sprite Fighters, but its operational range is... Well, it covers the entire map, since, you know, RTGs and all. Well then, the Viper has taken off, and I could actually build a second Viper. Yes, construct this. So, how does the situation on the map look? Trade fleets and flying scrolls. Yeah, you get back here and get your new wingman. This could actually be problematic, as the Viper is not as fast as the Sprite Fighters, limiting the overall speed at which the fleet can move. I don't mind. Actually, you are probably going to need some more resources, don't you? Yep, you have material storage and energy storage as well. And no fuel storage, as it should be. Okay then, join the first Aero Corps. Oh well, they are still reasonably fast. Okay, what to attack next? Now that I have a little bit more firepower at my disposal, I would like to take this resource zone before it is completely drained. And yeah, you go there. By the way, I will take quite a lot of time to position my forces carefully on the battlefield and to set them up correctly so that the result is actually the best I could achieve in battle. Yep, I'm ready. Battle begins. Okay, Vipers. Time to show what you can do. Yeah, they have two missiles, exactly the same as the Sprite Fighter. Heavy missiles, and they should be suited to take out any unarmored opponents, like this unfortunate resource outpost right there. The simple laser that serves as a nose gun is just a little bit more damage on top. Oh, any missiles? Ah, there you are. Yeah, the Sprite Fighters missiles are not that maneuverable, but they make up for it with additional amount of warheads. Actually, one thing I don't like about the Vipers is the howling of those simple lasers. This is actually a little bit a pain, yeah. Okay. Well, that went better than expected, actually. I've taken over the first... I've destroyed the first enemy outpost. And... yeah, these aircraft should be able to handle almost anything that the Deepwater Guard can throw at us at the moment. But for now, I would like to capture this and construct a new outpost right here. Though I don't have the resources, I'm afraid. Maybe I do. Maybe I do. This is still called Starting Fortress. I have spotted another enemy. It is a flying squirrel moving to intercept. Well, I'm afraid, flying squirrel, you might be a little bit underpowered to deal with this air force for the moment. But for now, I would like to make use the services of our doc again. And where did I put this spawner? Where did I put this blueprint spawner? Oh yeah, there it is. I would like to spawn a logistic unit, which I will use to construct additional outposts. Yeah, since I'm playing this like an RTS, I'm not using, you know, just, let's say, aircraft that have one repair tentacle on board to construct outposts. I will use either carriers or dedicated construction units. That is just a little roleplay thing for this campaign. So, please build a constructor, and as the name might suggest, this constructor constructs other constructs. Are you being built? Yes, you are. And you should be able to properly leave the dock once you have been built.
Moving out.
Okay. Yeah, the constructor is powered by steam engines, not painted or anything. Oh, there we go. They have just sprung into action, and my first aero core is being blockaded. Unfortunate for the flying squirrel, since it's going to be destroyed. Yeah. Come on. Build this ship. I may not have enough resources to do this. Alright, before... Right before the constructor was being finished, the blockade has gone on too long, and now I have to set my forces up for battle. Set them up to engage the flying squirrel. This should be a fairly easy fight, actually. Go! And intercept this airborne rodent. Are squirrels considered rodents, though? I don't know. Interception complete. Thank you. And none of you have rammed each other yet. Wonders do happen, after all. Okay, time to construct a new outpost. The constructor is on its way, being propelled forward by two strong steam engines, and I will now have the chance to construct a little mine here in this resource zone, further increasing my income. Another flying squirrel. Well, isn't this just fine? So, with the zone captured, the flying squirrel has turned away. Interesting. Very interesting indeed. Now, while my initial outpost is being constructed here, my initial outpost in the form of a small mine, actually, it has been constructed already. Good. Very, very good. I noticed something on the map. With the new AI update, some factions may be skirmishing and battling with each other. For example, the Scarlet Dawn, and the Grey Talons will have battles. As you can see here, something has been destroyed, and you can see the wreck on the map. And of course, the White Flayers and the Steel Striders will attack each other and try to wipe one another out. Yeah. I hope I can join the fight rather soon, so that, you know, there has to be something left for us to annihilate. Okay, next target, an airship gantry with an atlas, a medium house, a small house, and a seabird cannon fortress. This looks like a promising target. But I think I have to make some preparations first. The base zone has accumulated more materials, which means I can strengthen my air forces even further. So, I originally planned to construct another aircraft, but I've noticed something. These two resource circles from the little mine here and the one from the base zone do not intersect. I mean, the circles intersect, but there is no chance of resources being transferred from here to the base zone, which means I might have to construct a logistics unit first. And for these for this short range of transfer, I will construct where are you? Construction. No aircraft, please. No aircraft for now. Logistics and a universal freighter. Yeah. This is a fairly simple unit. I will simply you set up correctly. I will set this down right here, so that it is right in the middle of these two intersecting resource circles and enables the transfer of resources from this the resource zone to this one. It will serve as a pylon, yeah. But I will use a full-fledged resource freighter for now, because this one will serve another purpose later on.
Water mode at your service. Moving now. Moving now. Moving now. Moving now. Moving now. Receiving. Moving now. Receiving. Moving now. Receiving.
Listening.
Receiving. Receiving. Moving now. Moving now.
Now just taking a little moment to set up the supply, well, route. It isn't exactly a supply route, just a supply configuration. Stay inside the resource zone, please.
Moving out.
And there we go. Supplies are being transferred from this resource zone to this one. Good. Very good indeed. I have enough.
Receiving.
I have enough resources for another construction project. And I think I've decided what I want to build. So, a little bit of time has passed and I have built the Devastator. A certainly potent fighter bomber that I've constructed in careful there. That is a reference to the Devastator from the video game classic Crimson Skies, which I absolutely love the aircraft designs of. Now, it is now joining up with the first Aero Corps, and then they will be beginning the attack on the airship gantry that also has an Atlas, apparently. And further plans are to then raid the fishing village, completely annihilating it, capturing more zones here, and placing a radar satellite on the border to Onyx Watch territory, as well as taking over this resource zone of Captain Nick's last request, as this is certainly a smart move to do. Okay, merge please. You are once again called Sprite Fighter. It's a shame that the fleet name doesn't just get carried over, but oh well. Oh yeah, and the Devastator should be the squadron leader.
Moving out. Listening. Moving out.
Yep.
Moving
out. There you go. And there you go. Now then. You are fueled up, ready to go, and attack that airship gantry. Are there any incoming threats? Not yet, actually. Not yet. Yeah. Start the air assault. Okay, setup should be like this. They are in formation. I'm on board the Devastator. UI on for this fight. Actually, no, this looks better. And yeah, slider to the max, and all units are deployed. Let the air raid begin. Okay, the Atlas has been constructed and is now the primary target for all forces, since its flak weaponry can do quite a lot of damage to my lighter fighters, like, you know, the Viper or the Sprite fighters. Okay, looking good so far. One weapon has been taken out. This Sprite fighter pilot is feeling very, very dangerous, as it seems, since he took a dip there. Don't let the Atlas recover. Oh, that's a Viper. Yep, the Viper has been taken out, I think. Good thing I've constructed the Devastator. What's that gun doing, though? I'm slightly concerned for my Air Force. Concerned for the well-being of my Air Force. Right, you're shooting straight up. Why is that? How are you doing? Sprite Fighters, fully operational. One Viper damaged. Devastator pulling some maneuvers, it seems. Okay. The Atlas is still priority target. There are the Sprite Fighters. And please keep in mind that the Sprite Fighters do have a limited supply of fuel, of course, since they are not deployed from a carrier now. And this means that I cannot stay in this battle forever. I think I need to reassign.
Engaging now.
The target. Though some of these missiles are, of course, radar guided, and they will choose a different target than the one I've assigned. Most likely the target with the biggest radar signature. Okay, there was a fairly large explosion on this Seabird cannon fortress, but it's unfortunately being repaired by the gantry. I feel like I need to attack this building next, since it seems to repair all the other nearby constructs. And the missiles seem to ignore the Atlas as well. But the Devastator is equipped with simple weapon grenade launchers. Oh, I should be able to go for the Atlas. But not yet, it seems. Okay then, while the Atlas is actually disabled, please
engaging now.
Select this airship gantry as your main target now. Oh, Looks like I spoke too soon. Some missiles are actually going for the Atlas. Yeah, but the repairs are problematic. This has to stop. How are my forces doing? Quite well, it seems. Missiles coming in from the Devastator and ripping a few blocks out of the airship gantry, and this Seabird Cannon Fortress is AI dead. But unfortunately, it's being sustained by the repairs from the airship gantry. Okay, a successful strike later, and the airship gantry is AI dead, meaning the repairs should cease, and not only the airship gantry will disintegrate, but also this Seabird Cannon Fortress. And the new target is apparently the Atlas, which has been devastated. Thank you, Devastator. You are doing what your name suggests. By the way, I originally built Devastator as a unit to attack early Great Talon airships for my Great Talon campaign, which will be in German. Okay, next target is the Atlas. Actually, those are some nice houses. Whoever built these houses did a really good job. You can never have too many beer kegs, after all. Nice. Wait, what's this? A simple laser? Looks like the Viper is back in action. Yeah, it seems to have recovered from being flung into orbit, apparently. As is the same with this Sprite Fighter. This heavy version of the Sprite Fighter, actually. Looks like I need to tweak the AI a little bit after battle, but this one is already coming back down to Earth. Good. Very good. Now, there we go. AI dead. Please continue to wipe out the remaining houses. It seems that the assault was a success, with only one Viper lost, and one Deepwater Guard base less on the field. Wait, what is happening there? There's a flying scroll over there that was attempting to attack my position. Okay. Yeah, I need to conduct some repairs, it seems, on the Viper here. But first I would like to construct another radar satellite, which has been constructed immediately. Nice.
Moving out.
This radar satellite should take the position here and guard it against any approaching enemy forces. Well, not guard, just serve as a kind of early warning relay. Moving to defend a location. I do not like this build-up of flying squirrels, actually. So, the next target is this large, medium, small, tiny house. Arblast, a coastal defense, and a Falkenhayn. I know that the Falkenhayn has two onboard fighters that it can deploy, so this will be interesting. Okay then, I have fueled up the Air Force, which has changed its name again. Ach. And it's now ready to go attack this outpost here, the fishing village. Coming from the sea, flying inland and blasting right off the Valkyries. I'm fairly certain I've seen this somewhere. Oh, the flying squirrels are trying to intercept, but unfortunately they are too late. I will just need to position my forces correctly and then the assault can begin. Yep, I will engage before the flying squirrels have arrived. Okay, let's see. We have a Viper. I would like actually for the Viper to stay a little bit in the back so that they are not targeted first. The sprite fighters are quite fast, actually. Can be moved over here, and then the Devastator coming in from this position. Yep, looks alright. Almost all my forces will be spawned in. The biggest battle size I'm going to use to ease the strain on my hardware and to actually follow the battle properly, not being confused by too many forces, will be 50k cubic meters. Let's do this. Alright then. All of units, priority target
engaging
is
now.
Not the Duster Marine, but the Falkenhayn.
Engaging now.
There we go. EMP missiles have been fired, and they have taken out the Falkenhayn rather early. This is good, this is good. One enemy taken out of the picture, and this
engaging
coastal defense
now.
Here is the next target. Although, you know, with the thing with radar-guided missiles is they like to choose a different target than the one you actually want to be targeted. Come on! Devastator, do your thing! Yeah, not so much actually. Those missiles went completely somewhere else. Looks like they have taken out this windmill. And how's the damage? One Viper has taken some damage, actually. One is still airborne. Where is the other Viper? Oh, airborne as well. Yeah, they can take a hit, but not too many, actually. Good, good, but this missile turret is still operational. And my flares being ejected from the Devastator don't seem to do all that much. Seems like I need to have a look at the blueprint in the designer. See what I can do. But one fairly successful missile strike later, and the missile launchers have gone silent. That's what I like to see. Now, Vipers, would you like to assault the remaining buildings here? I hope you do. Actually, no. You know what? These things need to be taken out first.
Now.
Buildings do not move, and these Duster Marines actually do. Well, this one doesn't. Not anymore. And this one, I think, doesn't either, since its movement capabilities have been disabled. Okay. One house down, just a bunch of block confetti. Viper, you're missing part of your wing. I'm sure you don't mind, though. Oh, these simple lasers. Yeah, all this howling. Ugh. I'm not a fan of them, but they do work. Especially if they are spammed. Okay. Seems like that the radar signature of this half-submerged Duster Marine is too low to actually be targeted by radar-guided missiles. A good thing to keep in mind. I hope I can deploy some naval units next, since I should have enough resources after this battle to deploy maybe the first little ship. This will either be a corvette or maybe a torpedo boat. We'll see. We'll see soon enough. An update on diplomacy. I'm at war with the Deepwater Guard. Who would have known? So, while I was setting up, or maybe adjusting, the Sprite Fighter's AI, the battle has been finished. Good. Very good. And there's some salvage lying around here, but not too much, I'm afraid. Actually, I have enough materials on board of my Air Force. This Viper has been repaired, good. Flying Squirrels have called off their attack, and the initial board sections have been cleared so far. This has gone quite well, actually. Actually, better than I expected. I will move the Constructor up next. The Constructor has a few oil drills on board, by the way, to initiate resource gathering and thus construction of a small outpost all on its own. Grouping to capture. Are you sure you want to do this, Rapier? Ah, well. I guess this is a battle to be fought another day. Yes. There we have it, the Devastator. In space. Yeah, with that being said, I hope you enjoyed this first episode of From the Depths, Quest for Nita, Complete Annihilation of My Enemies, and I would like to say goodbye from the war-torn seas of Nita. I am Der Heizmeister, and I hope I'll see you next time. Take care, and goodbye.